Grinkrak the Great leads his Looncourt into the darkness under the Gnarlwood, and somehow they've convinced themselves that they're formidable fighters. In this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint Grinkrak the Great and one of the squigs from the warband too. And by following this guide, you'll easily be able to paint up the entire warband. Now, as you can see here, we're painting Grinkrak the Great separately from his base, and this will just help us get to those harder to reach areas. And we need to undercoat the models, and for this, we've chosen to use grey sear. So grab your brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. So the first thing we're going to paint is the cloak on Grinkrak the Great, and for this we're going to apply Black Legion. Then we're going to edge highlight with Eschen Grey, spot highlight with Dawnstone, and then pick out the stitches on it in Wraithbone. So let's get some Black Legion, and we're going to put some on the palette just so that we can control how much is on our brush. There we go. Make sure you've got a good point on your brush. Then we're just going to apply that all over the cloak. Don't worry about being too neat at this stage, as we'll be painting over the other areas anyway. You might want to apply a second coat of this. Once the Black Legion's dry, we're going to use Eschen Grey to edge highlight the cloak. So just use the edge of your brush where you can. Next, we're going to use Dawnstone, and for this we're going to do a spot highlight. So this means just picking out the most prominent edges and tips. Next, we're going to use Wraithbone to pick out the stitches on the cloak. Take your time and be as neat as you can with this, but if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with some Black Legion. And with the cloak done, we're now going to move on to the yellow areas. So for these, we're going to apply Bad Moon Yellow, then shade over with Cassandra Yellow and highlight with Screaming Skull. So we're going to take some Bad Moon Yellow onto the palette just to control how much is on our brush. There we go, make sure there's not too much. Roll your brush to a point. Then we're going to be picking out those yellow areas. So this is things like the shoulder pad and the small moons. Once that Bad Moon Yellow is dry, we're going to apply Cassandra Yellow over those areas. This just gives us a little bit of depth in the recesses without changing the colour. When that's done, we're going to edge highlight with Screaming Skull. So again, use the edge of your brush where you can. Now the yellow is done, we're going to move on to the skin. So for this, we're going to use Gutripper Flesh, Mephiston Red, Croak Green, Nurgling Green, and Screaming Skull. So we're going to start with some Gutripper Flesh, get some onto the palette. There we go. Then we're just going to pick out all those skin areas. I'm just going to start on the hand down here. Next, we're going to use Mephiston Red to pick out the eyes. I'm using a small airbrush for this, as it can be quite fiddly, so just take your time. Next, we're going to apply Croak Green all over the skin and also the eyes. Again, this will just get into those recesses without changing the colour too much. Once that's dry, we're going to use Nurgling Green to pick out the raised edges of the skin. This will just give us a nice subtle highlight. Now we're going to use Screaming Skull to dot the eyes. Really take your time here, it might help to hold your breath if you can. And with all that done, we're now going to move on to the metallics. So for these, we're going to base coat with Iron Hand Steel. So let's take some onto the palette. We want to add a little bit of water just to thin this down. There we go, then roll our brush to a good point And we're just going to pick out all the metallics on the model. You might want to do a couple of layers of this. If you've chosen to keep the miniatures separate from the base like we have, don't forget to now also paint his boot too, as this is attached to the base. And with the base coat done, we're now going to move on to the next stages. So we're going to use rattling grime thinned down with contrast medium. Then we're going to highlight with Ironbreaker. Then we'll be using White Scar and Frost Heart to create a glowy effect in the skull's eyes. So let's get one part contrast medium onto the palette here. Clean off the brush and make sure to dry it as well. Then one part rattling grime and add that to the mix there. There we go. Once that's mixed together, we're going to just apply that all over the metallics. Doing this, it'll just create a nice grimy effect on all those metallics. Next, we're going to use Ironbreaker to pick out all the edges of the metallics. So next we're going to use White Scar, and we're going to just put this in the eyes of the skull here. Doing this creates a nice base for the contrast paint to go over the top, and it's going to help us get that glowy eye effect. Next we're going to apply Frost Heart over that white. You can see that's a little too strong, so just clean off your brush. And we're going to use that to soak up some of the excess. That'll help give us that nice glowy effect we're looking for. And with that done, we're now going to move on to the brown areas. So for these, we're going to use Steel Legion Drab, then Agrax Airshade, then we'll highlight with Baneblade Brown. So let's get some Steel Legion Drab onto the palette. And we want to thin this down with a little bit of water, just to make a nice smooth consistency. There we go. Roll your brush. And then we're going to just pick out all those brown areas. So this is the wood on the staffs here. And we also need to do the pouch at the back. Next, we're going to apply Agrax Earthshade all over those brown areas. Now we're going to use Baneblade Brown to pick out the edges of all the brown areas. So again, use the edge of your brush where you can, as this will do all the work for you. With the brown done, we're now going to move on to the cream areas. So this is the cream cloth and some of the cream mushrooms too. So we're going to use Wraithbone, Skeleton Horde and Screaming Skull for these areas. So let's get some Wraithbone onto the palette. Definitely want to add some water to that just to thin it down. There we go. Make sure there's not too much on your brush. And then we're just going to pick out all those cream areas. So this is things like the cloth on the staffs and also these cream mushrooms up here. You'll probably want to do a couple of coats of this. And the next step is to apply Skeleton Horde all over those areas. As before, if you find it pooling too much anywhere, just clean off your brush and use it to soak up the excess. Once that's dry, the next thing to do is pick out some of the edges with Screaming Skull. We don't need to highlight every single edge, just the more prominent ones. And now those areas are finished, we're going to move on to the red mushrooms. So for these, we're going to use Wraithbone, Mephiston Red, Agrax Earthshade, and then White Scar. So let's get some Wraithbone back onto the palette. Add some water. A little bit more. There we go. And then we're just going to be using this to pick out the stalks of the mushrooms. With that done, we're going to paint all the caps with Mephiston red. Don't forget to do the mushrooms in the pouch at the back of the miniature too. Now we're going to apply Agrax Earthshade all over those mushrooms. Doing this not only shades the mushrooms themselves, but helps them blend into the areas that they're connected to. Now we're going to add the dots to the mushrooms using White Scar. Now all the red mushrooms are done, we're going to move on to the blue one at the top of the staff. So for this we're going to use Wraithbone and Lothurn Blue, then we'll shade with Agrax Earthshade and Drakenhof Nightshade, then highlight with Blue Horror. So let's get some Wraithbone back onto the palette. Again, thin it down. A little bit more. There we go. Then we just need to pick out the stalk of the mushroom at the top there. And now we're going to paint the cap of the mushroom with Lothurn Blue. Probably want to do a couple of coats of this. Now we're going to apply Agrax Earthshade to the stalk. Again, this will shade it and help it blend into the staff. Next, we're applying Drakenhof Nightshade to the cap. Next, we're going to use Blue Horror to pick out some of the edges of the mushroom. We're also going to use this to do some dots at the top. And with that mushroom done, we can now move on to the base. So for this, we're going to use Wraithbone, then Mephiston Red and Nightlord's Blue. Then we'll be painting the stone with Mechanicus Standard Grey and shading the whole thing with Rattling Grime thinned down with Contrast Medium. So let's take some Wraithbone onto the palette again. And as before, we're going to thin that down. There we go. You don't have to worry about being too neat at this moment in time. We'll be painting the rest in a minute anyway. And for this, we're just going to pick out the mushroom stalks. The next thing we're going to do is use Mephiston Red to paint one of the mushroom caps and also the insect on the base. With those two areas picked out, we're now going to use Nightlord's Blue on the blue mushroom cap. And now that's done, we're going to use Mechanicus Standard Grey to paint the rest of the base. So this is all the stonework. And with two coats of that done, we're now going to apply Rattling Grime thinned down with Contrast Medium. This is a mixture of one part medium to one part Rattling Grime. We'll be applying this all over the base and the mushrooms and the insect. And the next thing we're going to do is apply a dry brush of Terminator Stone all over the base. So I've got a small dry brush here and I'm going to take some of the paint out onto this paper towel here. And I want to work off as much as possible, so I'm just leaving a small amount of paint on the bristles. That's about right. Then we're just going to lightly brush that over the texture on the base. Terminator Stone is a specially designed paint designed for dry brushing, but if you haven't got this at home, you could use Screaming Skull to achieve a similar effect. And with that stage finished, we can now fully assemble the miniature and paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches the rest of your warband. In this case, we've chosen to use Mechanica Standard Grey. And now Grinkrak the Great is finished, we're also going to show you how to paint one of the squigs of the warband too. So to do this, we're going to use Blood Angels Red, then highlight with Wild Rider Red and Fire Dragon Bright, and then pick out the claws using Black Legion. So let's get some Blood Angels Red. We're going to put it on the palette, again to control how much is on our brush. We actually do want quite a lot of paint on the brush for this one. Here we go. Then we're going to apply that all over the body of the squig. When using contrast over large areas, it's actually better to apply it quite heavily, as this gives a better natural highlight. If you find it pooling too much, just clean off your brush and use that to soak up the excess. Also, make sure you work in small sections on the model, as this will make sure that the paint dries evenly and we get a consistent finish all over. Next, we're going to use Wild Rider Red to highlight all the edges of the muscle tone of the squig. Make sure you thin this down on the palette with some water, as we do want this to be quite thin and subtle. With that done, we're now going to use Fire Dragon Bright to do a thinner edge highlight. With this, we're just looking to pick out the most prominent edges and raised areas. We're also going to use this to pick out the eyes. With that highlight done, we're now going to use Black Legion just to pick out the claws. And with those areas finished, we're now going to move on to some of the other details. So we're going to basecate these using Iron Hand Steel, Bugman's Glow and Wraithbane. So let's get some Iron Hand Steel onto the palette. Need to add a little bit of water just to thin it down. And as always, roll your brush to a nice point. Then we're just going to pick out that metalwork on the horn here. And with that done, we're now going to use Bugman's Glow to pick out the lips. Just take your time here and be as neat as you can, as we want to avoid getting any on that skin we've already painted. Next, we're going to use Wraithbane to pick out the teeth and also the rest of the horn. And with those base coats done, we're now going to move on to the next stages. So for these, we're going to use Targhor Raid Shade and Agrax Earthshade. Then we'll move on to Bugman's Glow and Screaming Skull. So let's get some Targhor Raid Shade. I'm going to pop some onto the palette just to control how much is on the brush. Here we go. And we're going to be applying that over those lips. And now we're going to use Agrax Earthshade on those cream areas. We're also going to use this on the metalwork. And once all that's dry, we're going to layer up the raised areas of the lips with Bugman's Glow. Just make sure when you're doing this that the paint's quite thin, as we want it to be quite a subtle effect. Next, we're going to highlight the cream areas and the lips with Screaming Skull. And now our squig is finished, and by following the techniques shown in this guide, you can easily get the rest of the warband painted up too. Now Grinkrak the Great and Grib de Wonky Lance are finished, ready to head out on quests they might, miraculously, survive. So there's just a couple of things to remember when you're painting these miniatures. When you're edge highlighting, make sure you keep a nice fine point on your brush and use the edge of your brush to do the highlight where possible, as this will do most of the work for you. Also, when you're using shades and contrast, be sure to work in small sections. This will stop the paint drying out too quickly and make sure we get a nice consistent finish across the miniature. Well, that's the end of the video. We hope you've enjoyed watching and we hope you have great fun painting your own miniatures. We'll see you in the next one. Bye!